Morning to all. Today we are discussing about area capacitance of layers. So in this topic we are estimate the capacitance of the different layers. Okay, coming to the introduction, from the concept of the transistors, it is apparent that as gate is separated from the channel by gate oxide and insulating layer, it has capacitance. Similarly, different interconnects run on the chip and each layer is separated by silicon dioxide. Okay, we know that when we are fabricating the MOSFET, okay, we are using the different layers such as polysilicon layer, okay, and N diffusion layer and P diffusion layer and substrate layer. Okay, for example, you can observe this figure. Okay, here having the, this is the gate. Okay, and this is, we are considered the substrate, and in this have the N diffusion layers. Okay, so here forming a capacitance. For example, the gate and substrate is separated by the silicon dioxide layer. So here the gate we are considered the one plate and the substrate we are considered the other plate. So these two plates having the direct material, that is silicon dioxide layer. So this is, we are considered the one capacitance. So in this topic we are estimate the how these all layers are offers the capacitance values. Okay, and in this figure, for example, this is the gate and this is the N diffusion layer. So these two layers are separated by this dielectric material, therefore here forming a one capacitance. Similarly, for example, this is the N diffusion layer and this is the P type substrate, therefore here also forming a one capacitance. It means that when we are considered the two layers, okay, the two layers are separated by the silicon dioxide layer, therefore there existing a capacitance. Okay, and next point, for any layer, by knowing the dielectric thickness, we can calculate the area capacitance as follows. Capacitance C equal to epsilon A by D Faradays. We know that epsilon equal to epsilon naught into epsilon ins into A whole by D, where D is the thickness of the oxide and A is the area of the plates, and epsilon naught is the permittivity of the free space, and epsilon ins is the relative permittivity of insulator. Okay, so when we are estimating the capacitance of the any layer, we are using the formula capacitance equal to area capacitance into area. Okay, so for example, with respect to this formula, we want to estimate the area capacitance equal to C by A. So that is, we are considered the area capacitance. Therefore, the area capacitance C by A, or we are calling him CA equal to epsilon naught into epsilon ins whole by D. Okay, with respect to that, we are estimate the area capacitance. Okay, now you can observe this table. This is the area capacitance of the different layers. Okay, and we are using the different technologies. Okay, coming to the first one, gate to channel. For example, if you use the 5 micrometer technology, it can offer the area capacitance equal to 4 into 10 power of minus 4 picofarad per micrometer square. Okay, and the gate to channel offer the capacitance is 8 into 10 power of minus 4 picofarad per micrometer square. And similarly, 1.2 micrometer technology should offer the capacitance is, that is area capacitance is 16 into 10 power of minus 4 picofarad per micrometer square. Okay, and in this bracket values should indicate the relative values. Okay, and coming to the diffusion layer, the diffusion layer in the 5 micrometer technology, the capacitance value equal to 1. Okay, 1 into 10 power of minus 4 picofarad per micrometer square. Okay, and coming to the 2 micrometer technology, the area capacitance equal to 1.75, and in this 1.2 micrometer technology, the area capacitance equal to 3.75. Okay, for example, we are considered the metal 2-2 substrate. Okay, the metal 2-2 substrate in the 5 micrometer technology offer the capacitance equal to 0.2, and the 2 micrometer technology offer the value equal to 0.17, and similarly 1.2 micrometer technology to offer them area capacitance equal to 0.17. So in this way we are consider them area capacitance values of the different technologies. Okay, now we are
discuss the standard area capacitance. The standard area capacitance is denoted by square of Cg. Okay, this is the square and we are written as Cg. The area capacitance or the standard area capacitance can be defined as the gate to channel capacitance of minimum sized as MOS transistor. Okay, so we know that the minimum size of the MOSFET, the width and length is 2 lambda. Okay, so with respect to this width and length, here forming a one square area. So how much capacitance offer that square area, we are called as standard area capacitance. This standard area capacitance is denoted by square of Cg. Okay, so the square of Cg may be calculated for any MOS process as follows. Okay, for example, we are considered the 5 micrometer technology. Okay, so we were estimating the standard area capacitance. So first we are calculating the area. So here the width and length of the this 5 micrometer technology is 5 micrometer width and 5 micrometer length. Therefore, area equal to 5 micrometer into 5 micrometer, we got them 25 micrometer square. And the capacitance value. So with respect to the this table, we are considered the gate to channel capacitance value is 4. Okay, here we are considered the gate to channel capacitance is 4 into 10 power of minus 4 picofarad per micrometer square. Therefore, here we are considered the area capacitance value is 4 into 10 power of minus 4 picofarad per micrometer square. Therefore, the standard area capacitance, that is square of Cg, equal to area capacitance value into area. So here the area capacitance value, how much? 4 into 10 power of minus 4 into 25 micrometer square. We are simplified this values, we got the 1 square Cg value equal to 0.01 picofarad. Okay, for example, if you are design the 2 micrometer technology, the area equal to length and width are equal to 2 micrometer to 2 micrometer, we got them 4 micrometer square. Okay, and the area capacitance value, we know that this table, the gate to channel capacitance in this 2 micrometer technology, what is the value? 8 into 10 power of minus 4 picofarad per micrometer square. So here area capacitance value equal to this value. Therefore, the standard area capacitance value is 1 square Cg value in the 2 micrometer technology equal to area capacitance value, that is 8 into 10 power of minus 4 picofarad per micrometer square into area equal to 4 micrometer square. Okay, now we are simplify this all values, we get the standard area capacitance value equal to 0.032 picofarad. Okay, now for example, if you are using the 1.2 micrometer technology, the area equal to length and width both will be equal, then we are simplify this 1.2 micrometer into 1.2 micrometer, we got them 1.44 micrometer square. And the area capacitance of, okay, this gate to channel value from the table is how much? 16 into 10 power of minus 4 picofarad per micrometer square. Okay, now the standard area capacitance, that is square Cg, equal to area capacitance value into area. Now the area capacitance value, how much? 16 into 10 power of minus 4 picofarad per micrometer square into 1.44 micrometer square. Now we are simplified these values, we get the standard area capacitance, that is 1 square Cg equal to 0.0023 picofarad. Okay, so based on the technologies, okay, the standard area capacitance value can be varying. Therefore, the standard area capacitance should depend upon the these all technologies. Okay, now here we are considered the one of the strip line. Okay, so we are estimating the this strip capacitance. Okay, for example, this strip we are considered the metal, and the same we are considered the polysilicon, and we are considered the n diffusion layer. So first we are estimating the relative area. The relative area of this layer is width. Okay, here the width equal to how much? 3 lambda, and length equal to how much? 20 lambda. Therefore, the width and length equal to 20 lambda into 3 lambda whole by the minimum feature size of this layer. We know that the minimum feature size equal to 2 lambda into 2 lambda. because the width equal to 2 lambda and length also 2 lambda. Therefore, the minimum feature size equal to 2 lambda cross 2 lambda. Now, we can simplify this all values. We get the relative area equal to 15. Now, consider the area in metal 1. It means that now we can assume this layer is metal 1. Okay, now we estimate the how much capacitance offered this metal 1 layer. Okay, therefore the standard area capacitance, that is 1 square cg, okay, equal to relative area into relative capacitance value. Okay, the relative area equal to how much? 15 into the relative capacitance value. From this table, the relative capacitance value, that is the relative area capacitance value of the metal 1 to substrate. Okay, so what is the value? 0.075. Okay, in this bracket value can indicate the relative area capacitance values. Okay, so the value equal to 0.075 into square cg. Now this, you can substitute in this equation, we get the capacitance of that layer equal to 1.125 square cg. For example, this is we are converted in terms of the Faraday's. Okay, for example, if we are designing of this layer, we are using the 5 micrometer technology, the 1 square cg value equal to how much? 0.01 picofarad. So replacing this square cg by 0.01 picofarad, then we get the value in terms of the Faraday's. Okay, so for example, we are considered that layer is the polysilicon. Therefore, the capacitance of that polysilicon layer, okay, the overall capacitance equal to relative area into the relative capacitance value. So we know that the relative area of that layer equal to 15 into, from the table, the relative capacitance value equal to how much? Okay, the polysilicon how much? 0.1. So we are considering the 0.1 into square of cg. Now we can simplify these values. We are getting the capacitance of that polysilicon equal to 1.5 square cg. We know that if we are used the 5 micrometer technology, the 1 square cg value equal to 0.01 picofarad. Now that value you can substitute in here, we are getting the total capacitance of that polysilicon layer. Okay. For example, if I consider this layer is the n diffusion layer. So we are estimate the overall capacitance of this layer. Therefore, the overall capacitance of that n-type diffusion layer equal to, okay, we are considered the relative area into relative capacitance value. So already we are estimated the relative area. So what is the value? 15 into the relative capacitance value of the n diffusion layer. So what is the value? N diffusion layer, okay, here we are considered the 0.25. okay, the relative capacitance value equal to 0.25. that value substituting in this equation, now we are get the 15 into 0.25 square cg, therefore 3.75 square cg. Okay, for example, we are required the answer in terms of the picofarad. Replace them, this 1 square cg equal to 0.01 picofarad. Now we are simplify that values, we are getting the answer in terms of the picofarads. Okay, so in this way we are estimate the capacitance of the different layers. Okay, thank you.